A lot of talk this week is about the new king and his sons, William and Harry. But one of the people I've been thinking about is Kate, our new Princess of Wales. What enormous shoes she has to step into. I mean, that name, Princess of Wales, is so synonymous with her late mother-in-law. It must be very intimidating for a woman like Kate to think about taking on the mantle of that title. King Charles has been very decisive. He hasn't waited until his coronation to give this title to his son William and his wife Catherine. They are the Prince and Princess of Wales, but if you think about what Catherine has been dealing with this week, the very day that her children starts their new school, she drives to them possibly already knowing that Granny has died and that she has to pass on this information to her children on this very first day of school. Louis said very sweetly that Granny would now be with Grandpa, with Great-Grandpa, which is a really lovely, sweet piece of information which she passed on. But behind the scenes, this must have been an enormous few days for Catherine. She's taken on a new role herself, but she's also got to teach her very young children, aged 9, 7, and 4, that they're so names have changed. They are no longer George, Charlotte, and Louis Cambridge. They are now George, Charlotte, and Louis Wales. And any parent will recognize that when you've taught a young child how to spell their name, that's the name they're knowing to among their classmates. And these are children who have started a new school and being introduced to children, other children. Suddenly, they've got a new name. It could be quite destabilizing for these young kids who have just moved house, just moved school, and now, of course, have this great rupture in their family. I thought that Kate stepping out with her sister-in-law, Meghan, who of course we know accused her of bullying, must have been tremendously difficult. The Cambridge is now Wales, has moved to Adelaide Cottage, which is just a four-bedroom cottage. It doesn't have room for staff. It's just a very beautiful but smallish cottage. You have to hope that part of that move to be closer to Kate's parents has already shown itself to be beneficial. They are not far from where they now live. There will be immediate comparisons with the late Princess of Wales. I mean, they're both tall, very elegant women. Kate, of course, wears her late mother-in-law's engagement ring. She wants to have a very strong sense of family. Whereas William grew up in this fractured family, Kate, of course, grew up in a very close-knit family with her sister and brother. And I think Kate's decision, along with William, to move the family out towards Windsor means that that proximity to those schools, they can likely be day pupils rather than boarders. Now, Diana was apparently devastated that when her sons went off to boarding school, she wanted to keep them close by. For the short term at least, Catherine has obviously made that decision that she will keep her children close, and perhaps even through secondary school, they will continue to live at home.